What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today we're going to review Marvel. This one is a system for courses. You can create, store, and share your courses with this system. What I like about it is that it's super easy to use and get started. What I dislike about it is that it's since so easy to use, there's a lot of complex features that are missing. So if you're looking for something that you can just get started right away and super easy to use without that complexity, then this deal could be for you. But if you're looking for advanced features for your courses, then this deal might not be for you. So let's go jump over to see how much the deal is and what it actually does. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. All right, this is the deal that's going on right now, and it starts off at $69 for a lifetime deal. And let me show you what that actually gets you, because this is going to be the interesting part right here. So first of all, you have the option for white labeling, which is really good because that way you have your own brand. So you have your own custom domain, your own brands like logos, the footer, and all that is your own. And you don't have to display Marvel's brand. That's a pretty good thing. And the next thing is the license tiers, okay? So license tier one, which is $69, gets you 2 admins and 15 active courses. So you can't have more than 15 courses active with this deal. And you only get access to one academy, all right? You get unlimited learners, unlimited creators, unlimited draft courses, and advanced analytics. So basically, if you don't need to have many courses online, like active, then you're good with this deal. But if you need more admins and more active courses, license tier two would be the way to go. And if you want unlimited courses, then license three would be the way to go. Unlimited active courses, plus you get 2 academies. So you can have like 2 brands available with this one, okay? So those are the deal terms that are available right now. Like I said, starts off at $69. If you guys want to grab it, that link will be in the description. Now, let's go jump over to Marvel. These are my 2 test courses, and like I said before, it's super easy to use and implement. That's a really good part. What I dislike is the part where it's missing advanced features. Let me open up one of the courses I am working with, and let me click on edit, okay? So this is your actual editor. So this is where you're going to add your content right here. So if I click on this little plus button, we have these available type of sections, all right? So you have type of website, video, PDF, text, embed, where basically you can embed anything you want, and the quiz, all right? Let me show you one by one. So this one is basically text. So we have a title and we have the content, and these are the available elements that we can use. Yes, we can add images by clicking on this little clip, all right? Other element that we have is PDF. Basically, you can add a PDF link or upload your own. We can also add videos. For example, I just named these video tests, but you can add videos from YouTube, Vimeo, Wistia, and Loom. You can't upload videos, so they're not giving you storage for that. You have to only use the embed system from these companies available, all right? Pop quiz. Oh, I think, okay, here we go. Here's the pop quiz, title, description, and the options. Now, I think this is pretty much really basic. You can add more options if you like, but basically you just type in your options for whatever you want to use it for, that like a quiz. And well, in this case, I named it quiz, but it could be a test or whatever you want to use it. And a really good use case would be, for example, once they watch the video, well, you give them a quiz based on the video. So that way you know that they actually watched it. So they have to respond the right answer, okay? The other one we have is the embed system. No, that's not the embed one. Here it is. I added it twice. Let me delete this one. Okay, here's the embed system. In this case, what I did is I embedded a form, all right, from JotForm. That's what I did. Just give it a title, description, and you can embed content by link or by the embed code. So I added those. Those are the available options. Now, how are these actually displayed on a real life test scenario? Well, let me show you how this actually looks. So let's go into share to show you how this actually looks before we jump into users and settings. So this is my shareable link. In this case, I haven't connected my custom domain, but that's an option that's available. So let me open up an incognito mode system right here. And this course is meant to be open, all right? There's no registration needed. They could just jump into it, all right? So if I click on start, you're gonna see how this works. Basically, here's the content, and here are the steps. So 1 through 5, I could jump to next one. Here's my footer with my name. Let's mark this finished. The PDF test, we can download it. Let's mark this finished. The video test, okay, you can watch it or not. These are little things that I think should be implemented. For example, they should watch the whole video if they're going to go to the next step. So I could just mark it as finished if we want. This option's right here. I can select this. I can submit it. It's a quiz. Try again. Correct answer is option one. Nope, not option one. Option two. None of the options are correct. So see, those are little things that they should be implementing. Now, they don't give options to actually select which one's going to be the right one. Let's mark as finished. Okay, let's go ahead and that should give us a, what do you call it? A PDF with the, I have to sign in to actually get it. All right, but here's my logo and there's that. Like I said, super simple, not for complex users. All right, next sentence we have is the users that are in this course, which is me because I'm doing the test. The settings for this course, I could change how the way it looks, the design. For example, the title, description, course title, and the background image. The settings, for example, I can assign learners. So if I already have learners here, I can assign them. Assign groups. For example, when I have a bunch of learners, I can assign them to groups. So for example, group one could be an advanced group. Group two could be, starters, amateurs, something like that. And later on, I can create courses and tie them to that specific group. So that's why they have groups. In this case, well, I can assign them to a group that I might have. I can schedule the course start date. So for example, by default, it's gonna start off once we create it, but we can set a start date for a later date if we like, and the end date if we want to set that. Privacy, anyone with the link, which is what you saw right now, they could just start it and open it right now. SAS Master, which is the same thing as anyone with the link. That's what happens on my test. And restricted is the one that's gonna make them sign in because they won't be able to view the course unless they sign in. Big heads up here, they don't have yet an implementation to actually charge for the course, but that's something that's coming. There's two things that are coming that is really important. Let me show you right here. This is from them, and things that are coming right here, coming soon, is payment integration with Stripe. So no mention of PayPal yet. And Zapier. I wish they lean towards webhooks instead of Zapier because that opens up to use any type of automation platform. In this case, they are working with Zapier. I think they might change their mind once we add more feedback to them or give them feedback. Okay, so those are two things that are missing right now. Like I said before, these are things that are more complex and things that they should be implementing. This course, number two, I created it, but I put a lock on it. So that means they have to register to actually use it. Let me show you the link right here. Well, actually, it's restricted. Let's save it. Again, let me grab the link, copy, open incognito mode, and click just to watch it, all right? So I'm gonna open it up, and they're going to view this as default, okay? If they actually want to view the course, there's actually no content here. I'm just winging it for this one. They have to sign in to actually view the content, okay? So that's the way that you could restrict it. I hope they implement that payment gateway really soon because that's something that I think most people would want, even people who want a simple system, right? Because they don't want to charge outside and then give them access. So I don't know, could be something that people want. Okay, let's go into all courses right here. We could view available courses, assigned to me, drafts, and expired in case you set an expiration date, okay? Next thing we can view are the courses on the top menu. You can see the lessons. So it's just basically what the courses are inside of the actual course. So it's the lessons inside of the course. The design, if we want to change it. So there's these available designs and we can obviously create our own, okay? There's also the admin section, which is like a separate section right here. They give us the analytics. Analytics, I think, are pretty simple. They don't give a percentage of how much they went through it. Of a course, for example, view 17, users, courses, lessons, total views. You get that analytics. No more going on right here. That's all the analytics you have. Courses, okay? Here's the three courses. And for example, you get views, completion. And for example, it's just, there's nothing going on right here. And satisfaction. Well, we haven't done a real course, but you would get those analytics also, and the lessons, all right? So each lesson right here, the views, completion. Well, we actually do get the percentage on the completion. Courses, tags that we can add, the average satisfaction, and we can delete them through here. We also have the information for the users. Once they sign up, we're gonna view them right here. And we can assign them to groups, which is the next option right there. Like I mentioned before, we can create groups and we can add users there to later create courses specially for those groups. Certificates, there's these certificates by default. For example, I'm gonna edit this template. There's a logo. In the case, it's a white logo, so it doesn't look really good. We have the option to add the date or not, the course description. So for example, you can add whatever you want. We can add a signature, we can upload it or print to position right here. Automatically issued. So for example, if you don't want to do this manually, you can automatically issue it once the minimum level to issue is. So for example, you could say, hey, you know what? Once the user reaches 80%, then we can issue the certificate, okay? Next thing we have is the integrations. Again, integrations are really poor right now. These are the only ones that are available right now: HubSpot, Intercom, and MailChimp, which are pretty good integrations, but there should be more integrations in my opinion. But where it's going to really shine is when they add webhooks, because if we have webhooks, we can basically connect to anything we want. All of these, even HubSpot, Intercom, MailChimp, via webhooks and a bunch of other companies. So I hope they add that soon. Billing, which is just my information, and settings is something that we have to do. For example, the brand, it's SaaS Master, primary welcome message, secondary welcome message. Do we want to remove powered by Marvel? Like I mentioned in the beginning, it's white label. So yes, we can remove the powered by Marvel. And it's gonna, like you saw on my bottom course, it's gonna say SaaS Master. We can add the logo and we can go into domain. We can add our own custom domain. Like I mentioned before, it could be something like courses.sasmaster.net. Obviously, I would have to connect it via DNS so it actually works, okay? Languages, again, something that's really missing right here. There's only available English and Dutch. There's a wide variety of users that I know speak other languages and need other languages for their users. So they really need to pick it up right here. I mean, I don't know, a bunch of languages, even Spanish, which is a really popular one, Hindi, German, French, a lot of languages. The access policy and the danger zone. So that's the way we can delete it. But basically that is Marvel. Like I mentioned before, super simple to use platform for people who need something that's really easy to use, not complex, not a bunch of settings where it's gonna take forever to set it up, then this deal could be for you. But if you're looking for advanced features, like there's a bunch of features, trust me, then this deal might not be for you unless they plan to add those features later on. But basically, that's the deal that's going on right now. Don't forget that if you want to purchase it, that link will be in the description. I thank y'all for watching and I'll see you guys later.